Hey there, ever have one of those mind-blown moments? Well, brace yourself, because I've got something that's about to rock your world. Today, we are going to be integrating ChatGPT inside of Airtable. You've heard of Airtable, right? That spreadsheet tool that is like Microsoft Excel on steroids? Yeah, that one. It's like having a superpower for organizing, well, just about anything around your data. But wait, there's more. Imagine sprinkling some AI magic on top of all the amazing features you already get with Airtable. That's where ChatGPT comes in. Think about the automation and power that ChatGPT can do with the information inside your spreadsheets. And the cherry on top, you don't need to be a tech whiz to get in on this action. Nor do you need to pull out your credit card. It's all free. You just have to copy and paste one script that I made, plug in your API key, and you'll be on your way. It's all about making powerful tech accessible and fun for everyone. So whether you're a tech newbie or a business owner looking to up their game, stick around. We're about to embark on a wild ride into the future of tech. And trust me, you're not gonna wanna miss it. All right, so you can see here, I have Airtable pulled up and I have a simple spreadsheet and we'll just go through it here quickly. You can see here, I have a name column with just John Doe, Jane Doe, Michael Doe. We have a status column, which just is a select, so you have two options, to do and done. You have the product purchased, and then prompt one, which is a formula field, and that formula is just a text formula. So what that is it's just write a thank you email for customer, and we plug in the name, for purchasing the product, and we plug in the product name. And then we have another column called prompt one output. Now, what the script is gonna do, which I'll show you in a bit here, is it's just gonna look for a column called prompt and then a number, and then it's gonna take that prompt, feed it into ChatGPT, and then it's gonna take the output from ChatGPT and put it into prompt one output. Now, you can have as many of these prompts as you want. The script will automatically detect them. So you can have prompt 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, all the way up to as many as you really want and you can afford. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to lead you through creating another column here that ChatGPT will pick up and use. So we'll go ahead and we'll create a new column and we'll call that prompt 2. And it's going to be a formula. So we'll do write an email asking, and we'll say the person's name, to review the product, and we'll put in the product name. So there's the full prompt. Write an email asking John Doe to review the product and the product that they purchase. And we'll go ahead and create that field. And then we need that second output field. So we'll go ahead and put prompt to output. And we'll make that a long text. And we'll just hit create field. Now, in order to get this working with ChatGPT, we're gonna need a few things. The first is we're going to need the script. So I'll link this in the below. We'll go to the repository here and you're gonna click airtable-chatgpt.js. Now what this is just a JavaScript that'll run in Airtable and send those prompts to ChatGPT and put them back into the Airtable sheet. So just go ahead and click the copy icon, which will copy this whole file. We'll go back to Airtable. Now we'll go to extensions and then we'll hit add an extension and we'll look for scripting. Now I have it here in this big purple box. I don't know if everyone will have it there, but you could also just search it and then hit scripting and then click add. And then once that's added, you can go ahead and close this box and you can just paste in that script we just copied. Now, there's a couple other things we need. First is an API key from OpenAI. This is what will allow us to make those calls to ChatGPT. So go over to OpenAI, create an account if you don't have one already, and then when you go to your account settings, click API keys, and then click new, and then you can get an API key. And then go ahead and click copy. Now don't worry, I will delete that API key before this video is even posted. And what you're gonna do is just paste that API key in right here where it has that SK-XXX. Now you wanna make sure you paste it in between the two quotation marks. And then the second thing we need is the table name. So the table name here is table one. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go back into our script, and in this table name, we're just gonna write in table one. And now we should be all set. There's no saving or anything. All we have to do is just click the blue run button here, and it'll ask us to which record would we like to start from. Well, I'll go from one, and then it'll automatically run, and you'll see here that it'll start filling in the outputs with the outputs from ChatGPT. And there's the first one, and there's the second one, and it'll continue on all the way down through the entire spreadsheet. How awesome is that? Now imagine all the other use cases that you can have for this. It is not just for writing emails or text information. You can feed it numbers if you're doing like budgeting, or even instructions for project management if you need more clarification on details or status updates. These are all very good use cases for Airtable, and adding in ChatGPT just gives you that extra power and automation. So there you can see everything is run now. We have our prompt one output, we have our prompt two output. Let's go ahead and see what they look like. So here we go. Dear John Doe, I hope this email finds you well. I wanted to take a moment to express my sincere gratitude for your recent purchase of the iPhone 13 charger. Thank you for choosing our product and giving us the opportunity to serve you. At company name, we are committed to providing high quality products that meet our customers' expectations. We take pride in the exceptional performance and reliability of our chargers, and we are confident that you will find great value in your purchase. Your support as a loyal customer means the world to us, and we truly appreciate your trust in our brand. If you have any questions or need assistance with your new iPhone 13 charger, please don't hesitate to reach out to our customer service team. We are here to help you in any way we can. Once again, thank you for choosing our product, John Doe. We hope the iPhone 13 charger exceeds your expectations and enhances your charging experience. We look forward to serving you again in the future. Best regards. And then it has placeholders here for your name, title, and company name. Now, knowing this, we might have to refine our prompt so that it doesn't give us any of those placeholders. So we would go back to prompt one, click edit field, and write a thank you email for customer name, for purchasing the product purchased, and then maybe do not include any placeholder information. You know, now you shouldn't have to worry about those placeholders, and you can just copy and paste these outputs right into whatever integration email service you may be using. You also may have Airtable sync them automatically with the integrations they already have. And there you have it. The fusion of ChatGPT with Airtable isn't just a techie upgrade, it's a game changer. Remember those days when you'd wish for a smarter, faster way to get things done? Well, this is the answer to those wishes. If you like this video, please hit the like button or subscribe below, as it helps me to determine which content to continue making. If you have any trouble setting this up, please drop a comment below and I'll do my best to help. Now I get that adding a script and getting an API key may seem daunting, but the fact is, this is designed for everyone. Whether you're a tech enthusiast or someone who's just dipping their toes into the digital world, this feature is your friendly sidekick, ready to make your tasks a breeze. So to all you curious people out there, I hope this helps you in your daily workflows. Drop a line below and let me know how you've used this, and I'll catch you in the next video. Bye.